Congratulations.
Thank you.
This show became an absolute phenomenon now. Do you know why? Can you work
out? I don't know. No, it's like, I would say it's like baking a cake. I mean, not that I bake, but, you throw some ingredients in, a writer, producer, director, actors, and you've no idea how it's going to come out. And this, it has been a phenomenon to me because I've never done anything where so many people have come up to me in the street, in shops and things. And when it first went out, it was a shock. Actually, I've absolutely across the board, all types of ages, all types of people. It's been amazing, absolutely amazing. And I'm thrilled to be a part of it, actually. I'm just thrilled.
Oh, it's been a triumph. And Nicola, does it feel like a proper word-of-mouth phenomenon to me? Like, the audience got bigger and bigger as the weeks went on?
Yeah, and we knew it was good. We knew we were working something good, but it doesn't always translate that an audience wants to watch it.
Sure.
And that an audience keeps watching it. So I think we were all surprised, and just by the intensity of people's love for it.
Absolutely. And this cast, I mean, this is a platinum cast, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes.
We did okay.
How come we got all of these bits of Derek Jack? Did all these people just say yes immediately, or was it hard to get them?
No, everyone responded to the material really, really well.
So, Derek, would you like to say, what was it about the role that attracted you to this?
Well, it's the sort of role I'm never offered. I'm posh, I'm classical, I'm costume. I'm never asked to play Joe Bloggs, Yorkshire or otherwise. So when somebody had the vision and the chutzpah to ask me to play this part, I jumped at it. And it was the most wonderful, wonderful journey that we've been on with this fabulous class. The girls have said it. I mean, it had an extraordinary feel about it from the beginning. My only worry now is that somewhere I've put my Yorkshire accent and I can't find it.
Now that you've gone all posh for vicious. Yes, yes.
The thing about it is that not only the oldies are watching it, but the young people find something in it that is attractive to them too. I just think that people at home, in a sense, relax a little when they see the oldies like us.
Just watch it, doing it gently.
Just doing it gently, you know, as really as possible. No great traumas, no big stuff, but hopefully reflecting their own lives.
We never saw it as a drama about old people, older people, older relationships. We saw it as a love story. And I think that's because we put that at the centre of it, I think people see beyond age, beyond demographics, all that kind of material. And like Derek said, we did get a young audience as well. We got a real mixed audience. So hopefully it will have made some sort of difference.
Was it weird being up against yourself for Scott and Bailey? You and
Sarah? Yeah, it's a shame, because also Scott and Bailey's brilliant and should win as well. So it is sad, but it's
so that's a phenomenal
it's great as well. Yeah, amazing.
Amazing.
Yeah, it's a whole new world for me. I'm called sort of in sitcom hell now. But the interesting thing, I've only ever once done something like that. I guested on Frasier many, many years ago. But the thing that was most difficult for Ian and I think, was that we had five cameras and 350 people. So it was to decide who to play to, you know, whether you play to the audience in the room or the cameras. But we had a wonderful script, and because Ian and I have known each other for 50 years, we've rarely worked together. We have great trust, great companionship, great affection, and a great company. It was lovely. Hopefully. We've done a Christmas special to kind of remind people that we're still around, because Ian, of course, is a movie star, and he goes off and does the movies, and he's not free now, God damn him, till this time next year. So we can't do another one until he's free. But hopefully we will.
It's my first drama that I'd ever done, and I had more fun doing it than any other comedy I'd ever done. It was extraordinary, and I'd like to thank Karen, our producer, for making it such a pleasure to do.
I think you should memorise the names of the producers.
No, I said Karen. I was
but
right.
You pointed this way.
Oh, sorry. I don't know where she is. I know her name. I don't know what she looks like, Boyd.
Sorry. Any other questions from Her Majesty's Press? Sorry.